Let's take a look at the pH scale. pH means literally potential hydrogen. I'm not asking you to know that. What it does is it describes the corrosiveness of a substance. In other words, how likely one substance is to eat away at, corrode, in other words, another substance if they are applied together. It's a 1 to 14 scale, which I understand is a little bit funky because usually we operate in 1 to 10 scales, but this is a 1 to 14 scale. 7 is more or less in the middle and is non-corrosive. 7 is distilled water. Distilled water means there's nothing but H2O molecules, nothing else is dissolved in the water. If you pour distilled water over your hand from now until the end of time, it will not corrode your hand. When you go from 1 to 6.9, substances are said to be acidic or acids. And when you go from 7.1 to 14, substances are referred to as bases or basic or alkaline. Both directions, in the acidic and in the basic direction, substances become increasingly corrosive. In other words, going from 6.9 down towards 1, the substance will become increasingly corrosive, increasingly able to dissolve and destroy other substances. And the same thing with 7.1 to 14. As you go into the basic zone, substances become increasingly corrosive. Let's look at it. So here's a diagram of it. You can see 7 is in the middle as neutral, pure water. And then as we go to the left, you can see 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, milk, black coffee, tomato juice, apple juice, lemon juice, which also, by the way, sits right about where jalapeno pepper would be, gastric acid. And then as you go from 7 towards the right, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, an egg. How about that? Baking soda. You may very well have known that baking soda is a base. Hand soap, ammonia solution, bleach, and then concentrated solutions of alkalis, which would be something like Drano, for example. Something about the work you're going to do in today's lab. That photograph is of the ornamental fountain at Santa Ana College. It sits in the middle of our quad. Now, that ornamental fountain is something akin to a swimming pool, right? You have to treat that water. If you don't treat that water, what's going to happen? Instead of all of those lovely colors that you see the water pouring over the top of, it's just going to be green and mossy. So it has to be treated to keep that from happening. We're going to look at two water samples. I've actually done them for you, as you're going to see in another video. One is water from that very ornamental fountain, the day I took that picture. The other is bottled water. And as much as anything, this is about your expectations. What do you expect with bottled water? And what do you expect with water from a swimming pool or an ornamental fountain like that one you see at Santa Ana College? What are your expectations? If you buy a bottle of Aquafina, for example, what do you expect is going to be inside that bottle? If you went over and took a drink from the ornamental fountain, what are you expecting to taste? What we're going to look at is pH, chlorine, copper, and hardness of the water. And of course, there is a video following this in the module that has me checking out the pH, the chlorine, the copper, and the hardness of those two samples of water, the ornamental fountain and the bottled water. And then you're going to record the answers and then complete the quiz in the module. So the questions look like this. These are obviously not the questions, but they look like this. What time does this class meet? 10 a.m., 12:15, 4 p.m. Okay, we're going to assume it meets at 12:15, okay? So if it meets at 12:15 and you are looking at the questions and the answers in Canvas on the quiz, you would pick number 2. But the questions may very well have the answers scrambled. And by that, I mean that second question, which is the same question. What time does this class meet? 2, 12:15 p.m., 3, 4 p.m., 1, 10 a.m. And the answer remains 12:15 p.m., so you would click on number 2. Okay, I'm just letting you know that the answers are scrambled. You are looking for the correct answer. That is what you pick. Don't worry about the number sequence because this is the way Canvas scrambles answers. All right, let's give it a shot and see what happens.